So welcome kids to the Sunday School online classes. Today we will be reading a chapter from class 6 unit 7 introducing great men, Saint Anthony of the Desert. Before we actually read this chapter in detail, I think it's important to know this words which is mentioned on your slide, and that says, and everyone who left houses or brothers or sisters or fathers or mother or children or fields for my sake will receive 100 times as much and will inherit eternal life. Matthew chapter 19 verse 29. And you know, if you carefully go through this verse, you'll realize that, and when you'll read the chapter, you'll realize this is exactly what Saint Anthony of the Desert did. So what does this verse mean? It means that anybody who is going to leave everything or sacrifice, leave behind everything that they have, all the riches, wealth, fame, and follow God's path, will get 100 times of what they have sacrificed and will inherit eternal life. Now what is eternal life? Eternal life is a life that we are going to live after our death. So it's a life that is more closer to God, that is a life in heaven. So God says that if you leave all of this and follow me, you will have a wonderful eternal life, and you will have much more, you will receive in return much more than what you have lost. Okay, so on that note, we begin with our topic. And it's important that we start with understanding of these few terms which will be used in this chapter. So the first is monk or sannyasi is the other word, and the other one is monasteries. So who is monk? Monk is the one who abandons or sacrifices the world, their family, their possessions, their riches, and devote oneself fully to spiritual or God's work. And for them, they follow only two commandments, which is love of God. So for them, everything is God, and love thy neighbor, which means love everybody as your own. So monks actually follow Bible in true letter and spirit. And you know, this verse that is mentioned below in red is apt for to explain how monks live their life. So for monks, I think instead they have to clothe with the Lord Jesus Christ and do not think how to gratify the sinful desires of the flesh. Romans chapter 13 verse 14. So it simply means that you need to immerse yourself totally into Lord Jesus Christ and his way of working, and do not get distracted with the riches and with the other distractions that are in life. When you see a car, suppose you see a car, a beautiful car today, you see a beautiful girl today, you see a beautiful house, you should not get distracted. You should just keep your focus and dedication only and only towards Jesus. If somebody can lead that kind of a life, he's a true monk. Okay, and then now let's understand what this monastery means. So what monastery or deras means, it is simply a place where monk live. So because there are no distractions, people live in isolation there, they meditate and prayer. So a monastery is the building where monk live while they're practicing their religion. It is a Greek word, it comes from a Greek word which means a place to live alone, and monks and nuns go to these monasteries to live in isolation, and you know, so that they are away from the rest of the world and all the distractions. So okay, now we move on to our main topic, that is Saint Anthony. So what are we going to study in this chapter? We are going to read about childhood and his family briefly. What inspired him to choose monastic life, then his monastic life, some of his struggles and temptations, and his popularity and heavenly abode. So childhood, family and steps towards spirituality. So Saint Anthony was born at Kemen, an Egyptian town, in 251 AD to wealthy Christian parents. He lost his parents when he was just 19 years of age, and he was left with his lone sister. And so Anthonius and his sister inherited huge ancestral property because the parents were very rich. So he had a lot of money. So one day while attending the church, he listened to the gospel which read, "If you want to be perfect, go sell your possession and give it to the poor, and you will have the treasure in heaven. Then come and follow me." Matthew chapter 19 verse 21. So this is a verse from Bible, from Matthew, where God is talking to a rich man who came to him asking him that, what do I do to get an eternal life and how can I be a perfect man? So to answer to that question, he said these words to him that, if you want to be perfect, go sell what you have and give it to the poor, and then come and follow me, you know, you will have the treasure of heaven. So this is how he told him. So when Anthony heard this, it struck him, and he felt that Jesus is telling this to him, and he decided suddenly that he is going to follow this. So he went back home, took a stock of what the wealth and everything. He distributed all his wealth to poor, but he set aside some part of his wealth for his sister, because his sister was alone and she had to live. So he kept a decent amount for her and handed over her to a Christian family. They were known to take care of her, and he decided to start his monk life. So in his monastic life, how did his monastic life start and what did he do? So you know that what triggered him to be a monk. So he decided that he's going to spend his life alone in isolation. So he chose Egyptian desert initially for first 24 years to live as a monk, as a hermit, and spend the time in only prayer, meditation, and do some manual work, and abandoned everything else that he had in life. So he used to plant seeds and all that. So whenever he used to plant seedling, he used to recite prayers, hymns and psalms. So he maintained a very strict ascetic life. He ate only bread, salt and water, no meat, no wine for him. So he was absolutely simple, used to have simple food, pure vegetarian. Sometimes he used to eat only once a day and not eat for 2 to 4 days. So, you know, that's how difficult he lived his life. Imagine a person who had all the riches, who had big house, with a palatial house, lot of wealth, decides to leave all of it and, you know, just manage with that one time meal and that to just water and, you know, bread. So how difficult it would be for somebody to sacrifice all this. It's not easy at all. For us to leave, you know, skip one meal becomes a proper challenge. And this person just leaves everything just for the God, just only and only for the God. So people were astonished with his discipline and with his hard life and, you know, with the way he worked. So many wanted to kind of follow him, and slowly, secretly, a lot of people started following him. But he didn't want those, distractions. So he kept himself away from all of those followers and used to be in the cave in desert meditating all by himself. So like I mentioned that he used to be in the cave and away from, you know, all the distractions. So he used to, while he used to be in the cave and pray, there used to be demon and, you know, Satan's who used to distract him and fight with him and, you know, trouble him. And we know that Satan's and demons' job is to pull people away from, you know, godly work. So they were hell-bent and troubling him. So one day they all fought with him, troubled him big time. He retaliated, he tried to control him, he fought back. But they overpowered him and he was injured. And then his followers came and they, you know, took him away and they took care of him and he got recovered. And when he regained his consciousness, he said that, I want to go back to the same cave. So he was brought back to the same cave. And then he came, he called loudly Satan and demon. He said, come out, I want to face you. So they all came and they pounced on him. Suddenly a big, you know, bright light came and stopped them, and they found that all the demons were killed. And Saint Anthony was surprised, but he knew that it was God who saved him from those demons. And he thanked God and he asked God that, you know, thank you for saving me, but you did not come when, you know, they fought with me last time and you let me get hurt. So, God said that I was there even at that time, but I wanted to see how strong you are, whether you will run away when you are put under testing, or would you come out of this strongly. I'm happy that you fought with them strongly, and that is the reason today I came to protect you. So I'll be with you, and you'll be known throughout the world for your good works. So that, you know, since then his faith in God rose even more higher. So he spent his rest of the life in the desert, living that continuing with his monkhood. So in 104 years that he lived, he decided to go visit his parental town twice for two reasons. One was that to encourage the martyrs and to argue their cases in the court of justice. We know that people used to, you know, preach or work for Christianity and all were beaten and were martyred. So he went to argue their cases. Secondly, he went at the age of 90, and that was to fight against the heresy propagated by Arius. Now, Arius from Alexandria was also ascetic, but he was spreading false, false beliefs or false things about Jesus and, about Holy Trinity. He said that Jesus is not equivalent to God, he is not God, he is smaller to God, and, there is no relation as such. So, he did not like Saint Anthony, he did not like it. He went and he fought against that misbelief, that blasphemy that Arius was spreading, and he was appreciated. So these were the two significant, work that he did. And as he was getting older, towards the end of his life, he started getting that popularity. He was known all over the world, and he earned unprecedented acclaim for his, disciplined life, for his ascetic life, for his beliefs, for his works. A lot of people started following him to the desert, and he kept on increasing. So towards the end of his life, he started guiding them, preaching them, and started interacting and mingling with people. Now Saint Anthony was knew when is he going to die, and so before his heavenly abode, he had informed his followers or people around him to bury him in at a particular place. So he had identified his grave. So according to his instruction, he was buried in a grave in Egypt in 356 AD when he was 104 years. So this was the story of Saint Anthony. He was Saint Anthony the Great, was referred to as the father of monks or the father of Christian monasticism. So if let's go back to the first verse that we had read. So that word says that anybody who is going to leave their parents, fathers and all riches will get 100 times in return and will have an eternal life. So now you know that though he sacrificed all of it, but the kind of fame he has got and the name he has got, that after centuries also people remember him, he wouldn't have got if he was, leading that wealthy life. So God is right. Life may be difficult, there could be challenges in your way, but if you just stick to it and do not leave hope and you just work towards it, you will definitely will be appreciated by everybody. So that's the moral of the story. So now it's time to do some questions and answers. I'll read out the questions and also tell you the answer, but I'm sure by now you know these answers. What was the birthplace of Saint Anthony? It was Cayman, an Egyptian town. When did his parents die? When he was just 19 years of age. In which year was he born and when did he die? He was born in 251 AD and he died in 356 AD. Which biblical verse inspired him to do monastic life? That was Matthew chapter 19 verse 21. Which place did he choose for his monastic life? It was his Egyptian desert. How many times did he visit his parental house? He visited twice, and we know the reasons. How is he known the world over? He is known as father of monks. So I hope you would have enjoyed this chapter and you've got the moral of the story as well. So thank you, all the best, and I would encourage you to just read the chapter from the book as well. Thank you so much. Bye bye.
subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.